And the next lesson is dedicated to give an initial view of OpenBUGS. We use a practical application, the BPR application used in traffic studies, to illustrate the different steps of the process and the output, figures and information provided by OpenBUGS. Here you have the three windows that we have mentioned before. In the lower left corner, you have the command window. In the in the right side, you have the data window, and the initial is given in the upper left part of the transparency. Here you have the three tools that we have used: the specification tool, the sample monitor tool, and the update tool. We have mentioned before what these tools are for. And next, I'm going to describe a little bit the BPR travel time function. This function gives you the time required to travel a section of a highway. And T0 is the time required when there are no other cars and you are alone, so it gives you the minimum travel time. Alpha, beta, and gamma are parameters of the model. C is the capacity of the highway, or this segment of highway. And B and BR are the number of cars that are circulated in the same and in contrary direction, respectively. We can, of course, write this expression in dimensionless form using the asterisk variables. That is very important. We need to try to work with dimensionless variables to avoid problems. If we go to the existing literature, these parameters range in take different values, and these are the ranges, the normal ranges that can be found in the literature that will be used for building the model. To convert the deterministic model into random, because the alpha, beta, and gamma of the initial model are deterministic, so to convert them into random, what we do is we assume some distribution for this. For example, we assume that the mean value of the travel time is the one given by the formula, so that the formula, the deterministic formula, gives you the mean value of the travel time. But we assume that it is a normal distribution, and we need to consider not only the mean, but also the standard deviation of the variance. And then the parameters are assumed random, and there are, to simplify, we have assumed that alpha, beta, and gamma are uniform, and that sigma is a gamma with parameters very small, 0.001, which means that are non-informative. It is not exactly uniform, but it is close to the uniform. This is the commands table, and then you have several parts. First, on the top, we have the BPR example, the model, in which you define the mean value, mu of I, and then you write the formula relating this mu value as a function of the parameters, alpha, beta, and gamma, and the capacity, and the flows, R, and the reverse flow. Then you have to define the data. The sample is relative travel time of I, and then you need to say that it is a normal random variable with mean mu of I and dispersion tau. Next, you need to define the priors, the alpha, beta, gamma, and sigma. Then you define the first three priors as uniform densities with the corresponding parameters, and the sigma with a gamma, which is a non-informative gamma. And finally, you need to define the reparametrizations, because we use the dispersion tau and the standard deviation sigma, and you need to define what is the relation, and that is the one in the lower part of the transparency. If we use the OpenBUGS, you can obtain the densities of these parameters, so we don't answer with point estimates, we don't answer with confidence interval, we answer with densities. Our answer is the alpha, beta, and gamma, and sigma parameters have these densities. Of course, we can post-process these values, and we can calculate in a MATLAB program, for example, the densities, instead of using those given by default by the software. We can also obtain a very interesting thing that is consider not only variables alone, we can consider pairs or triplets of variables just to see if they are dependent or no. And then using a post-process and plotting these plots that you can see here, we can see, for example, that the beta and the alpha parameters are clearly dependent. The same occurs with the alpha and gamma, but beta and gamma are almost independent. So it is very interesting to study these things. Another way of having an idea of the dependence of the different parameters is the plot that you have in this transparency. First, we normalize the parameters between 0 and 1. And then we plot the different samples, but polygonals. And then we plot different segments, and you have this picture. And this picture allows you to see which pairs or which triplets are dependent and which ones are not. But these are 0, 1 normalized values of the sample. And this is the end of this lesson that shows you how to convert a deterministic model into a random one. As you can see, converting the model parameters into random leads to such a model. The Doodle tool, together with OpenBUGS, converts this in a simple exercise, but very useful. If you want to gain power in your models, converting them to random, you should not only read this lesson several times, but to incorporate what you have learned to your way of facing problems. We strongly recommend the reader to see the MATLAB codes to call OpenBUGS for this and other examples, which are included as complementary course materials.